Good morning. And Merry Christmas. It's good to see everyone here in the brave, the cold weather. For those of you that are joining us online, I hope you have a nice cozy fire that you're gathering around. Mr. Campbell and I thought we probably ought to light a fire somewhere in here. Bob, in a little bit we're going to light the Advent candles. We could all gather around to get a little bit warmer. Just a couple things this morning. We're continuing our Bible study on the Chosen series this coming Wednesday. We'll be here. By the way, that video clip that you just enjoyed was from Dallas Jenkins, the producer of The Chosen, and that was his first pilot, if you will. And for those of you who are at the last Bible study, we saw that Mary saved those swaddling clothes, according to the Chosen story, except for the one strip. And she said, I had given it to the shepherd. Now you see what's behind it, how she used that strip for the shepherd. Let's see if we got anything else in terms of announcements or prayer requests. Just continue remembering the folks on your prayer list. I would pass along, too, that I talked with Rose. That's a friend of Linda Jones, and she's becoming my friend almost, too. She is the lady that is providing care for Charles Farmer through the week, and she has asked that to see if the church family would continue sharing meals on weekends, at least through the end of January. And this weekend is covered, and next weekend is covered as well. So if you can help out on the other weekends in January, that would be awesome. Now, we wouldn't be Christmas morning if we didn't share some small tokens of appreciation to some of the people that make things happen here at Pleasant View Baptist Church, and especially here on Sunday mornings. And so Loretta's got several gifts, and I'll let her start with a table behind her. That's the easiest one to get to. And we're going to thank Aaron and Rebecca and Esther for their ongoing help back there each and every week. Aaron, he's a troubleshooter. Whenever we can need a problem or have a problem, we need Aaron, and he comes along and tries to fix it for us. And then we got our three, I don't know how we put the gals on the praise team. Plus, we got a new one today. Did you see that? Yeah, how about that? Missy, Caitlin, and Amanda, thank you for all you do each and every day. And Maureen. Maureen keeps me in line as the pastor, but the best part of her job is she's the connection with the congregation. And she makes everything happen. And those neat sayings that you see in the bulletin or on the emails and the like, those all come from Maureen. And so thank you, Maureen, for all you do. And I thank the church, too, for your ongoing support of all of us that are in part of the ministry group. It makes a huge difference today and every day. So I think it's time to sing. The ladies have a few extra songs today we're going to sing on this Christmas morning. So let's start with this first one, Born in Bethlehem. You know what? I didn't open with prayer. Let's pray right now before the ladies sing. Father God, we gather this morning on Christmas morning. Oh, our hearts are full of joy because we are celebrating the birth of Christ. And Father, as we await this morning the presence of the Spirit as He fills our hearts. And Father, we have hope through the Spirit, through You, through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And as this Christmas Advent closes today, we await the second advent, the second coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. In His name we pray. Amen.
Please stand and let's sing together, and let's sing out loud today. The praise group needs help this morning. We recruited help too.
Thank you. Jesus, born in a stable, humble Savior's birth. You left your throne in heaven above to live here on the earth. Baby Jesus, lying in a manger, crying for the world. The angels told the shepherds of the good news for us all. Hallelujah, the King is here, given for all men. For today the Holy Son of God is born in Bethlehem. And you saints, all peasants and all kings, and bow before the earth's Redeemer, let all voices sing. Hallelujah, the King is here, given for all men. For today the Holy Son of God is born in Bethlehem. Hallelujah, the King is here, given for all men. For today the Holy Son of God is born in Jesus, do you know you'll die for all our sins? Don't be afraid, for in 3 days you will rise again. You will rise again. Hallelujah, the King is here, given for all men. For today the Holy Son of God is born in Bethlehem. Hallelujah, the King is here, given for all men. For today the Holy Son of God is born in Bethlehem. For today the Holy Son of God is born in Bethlehem. In Bethlehem.
We got another one. Stand up.
The world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more let sins and sorrows grow, nor thorns infest the crown. He comes to make his blessings flow. Far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found.
Thank you. You may be seated.
In the last few verses of the Bible, Jesus identifies himself to us as the bright and morning star. Revelation 22:16, I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify to you these things in the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, the bright and morning star. The Hebrew word for morning is derived from a word meaning to split or to break. Hence, the morning star signaled that the light was about to arrive and drive the darkness away. Jesus, the morning star, came to reveal the light, the truth, and to drive out the darkness, the lies of Satan, to split the lies from the truth. Peter saw the Old Testament as a light that shined in a dark world until the morning star brought the light into our lives. 2 Peter 1:19. We also have the prophetic word made more sure, which you do well to heed as a light that shines in a dark place until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. Jesus has filled so many roles in our lives, and each one has been described by a title given to him, Emmanuel, God with us.
Emmanuel, God with us, Jesus of Nazareth. Lord, the Lord of our lives, the Lord of the universe. King, he is the King of Kings. As Savior, the one who has redeemed us from our sins. And as the bright morning star who declares that a new day has risen in our lives, one filled with God's truth and light.
Let's pray.
Jesus, you came to change our lives. You have taught us the many ways that you can do just that. This Christmas, may we find room in our hearts and lives for you to take that change to an even greater level. May our lives be your home. In your name we pray, amen.
They had a 4-inch sprinkler system, the 4-inch main above the ceiling on the fourth floor of building one there broke. And they lost power the other day for about an hour and a half, and they think the line froze, and that's when it broke, and they had water damage clear down to the lower level. And so there were a handful of guys, some more talented than me, like Bill, and we had our shop vacs, and there were several other volunteers and staff members there vacuuming up water. And we made a little bit of a dent, and then they called in the professionals. And the professionals arrived with all their equipment, these big, huge vacuum vans that you haul out hundreds of feet of hose, and they just suck the water right out of that carpet. If you've been to the Hope Center, one of the major areas that was impacted was the ballroom. And when Bill and I left, Pastor Nolan had said, hey, the pros are here. You guys have given it a good shot, put in several hours of help. Why don't you guys take off? Let the pros take over. And they were. They had taken care of the vacuum, water vacuum, the ballroom, and they would put fans in to move the air. They were turning up the heat a little bit and opening the windows so that the moisture would go out. See, I'd never know that, but the pros do. So we needed to pray for the Hope Center this morning as well. So this morning there are those that don't know the story of Christmas, and we need to lift them up as well in this morning. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, you are a most awesome God. And no matter how we see it portrayed, how we read it, it's all based on your word. 300 some Old Testament prophecies were fulfilled on that Christmas day with the birth of the Messiah. You came down to earth to walk among us, that you might be revealed unto us. And Father, in your awesome love, you sent your Son. And when we call his name in faith, we can find eternal life through you and your amazing plan of salvation. And Father, this morning we gather on this Christmas day, and our hearts are filled with joy. And Lord, it shouldn't be just Christmas Day. It should be every day, because it's a day you've given us, a day that we are called to serve you, a day that you are with us through the Spirit. Oh, Father, all glory to your name this morning. Father, we lift up those brothers and sisters in our congregation that need your healing touch. We're glad to see Linda back after a bout of illness, but we know there are so many others out there still battling illnesses of one kind or another. We lift up our shut-ins. Be with them, Father. Bring peace and comfort in their hearts. May they experience your awesome love and joy on this Christmas day. And Father, we lift up our partner in missions, the Hope Center. And so many times they're just leaning on you. And you've come through so many, so many times. I like Pastor Nolan's favorite line. Let's pray on it over the weekend and see what the Lord's done on Monday. Father, may we have that kind of faith in our lives as well. So we lift the center up this morning as they recover from the water damage. And I lift up each of my brothers and sisters gathered with us today. May indeed we be like the shepherds that we saw in the video clip this morning, rejoicing and anxious to share the good news. For as they put it, the people must know. It's in Christ's most awesome and beautiful name, Jesus Christ, that we pray this morning. Amen. Let's sing together a couple more Christmas carols this morning. Hark the Herald Angels Sing and Silent Night.
Just sing glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ our highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord. Him come, offspring of the virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh, the Godhead see, hail the incarnate deity. Please with us in flesh to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heavenly Prince of Peace, hail the Son of Righteousness. Light and life to all he brings, risen with healing. That he lay his glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the of God loves your love.
I'm not sure what Christmas traditions you have at your home. I'm sure there are some very special moments that you look forward to each and every year. As our kids were growing up, we loved to, on Christmas Eve after worship time, we would gather at our house and we'd have a birthday party, a birthday for Jesus. I remember one of those times we gathered, we had had Ron and Norma over, and we also shared in the movie Santa Claus and the Martians. That's a classic. Mystery Science Theater was what was portraying that. Nick probably knows why. I watched a little bit of Mystery Science Theater over the years. That wasn't a part of the tradition, but we still chuckled about those in the years past. You know, I think that there are so many different ways that we can celebrate Christmas through our traditions. But I think we ought to have a tradition of maybe sharing the Christmas story as well. So I went out and looked at several different compilations of the Christmas story, because actually you find the Christmas story in Luke and Matthew, as we all are aware of, but there's a little bit of it in John as well. Mark was brief. He was like the Reader's Digest of Gospels. We pretty much started with the ministry of Christ in Mark's Gospel. So I found this one. It's written by James Watkins, and I'd like to share it with you this morning. The Christmas Story in Chronological Order by James Watkins. You know, Jesus is God from eternity. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him. Without Him was not anything made that has been made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness hasn't overcome it. The Word became flesh and lived among us. We saw His glory, such glory as of the one and only Son of the Father, full of grace and full of truth. Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man whose name was Joseph of David's house. And you can check out his family tree in the scriptures if you'd like. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, you highly favored one. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was greatly troubled at the saying, and considered what kind of salutation this must be. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and give birth to a son, and will call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. There will be no end to his kingdom." And Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, seeing I am a virgin?" And the angel answered her, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, also the Holy One who is born from you will be called the Son of God. Behold, Elizabeth, your relative, also has conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren, for nothing spoken by God is impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, the servant of the Lord, let it be done to me according to your word." The angel departed from her, and Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste, into a city of Judah, and entered into the house of Zacharias, and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. She called out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Why am I so favored that your greeting came into my ears? The baby leapt in my womb for joy. Blessed is she who believed. for there will be a fulfillment of the things which have been spoken to her from the Lord. And Mary said, My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit has rejoiced in God my Savior, for he has looked at the humble state of his servant. For behold, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy is for generations on those who fear him. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in their imagination of their hearts. He has put down princes from their thrones, has exalted the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things. He has sent the rich away empty. He has always given help to Israel, his servant, that he might remember mercy. And he has spoke to our fathers, to Abraham and his offspring forever. And Mary stayed with her for about 3 months and then returned to her house. Now Joseph, her husband, being a righteous man and not willing to make Mary a public example, intended to put her away secretly because of her pregnancy. But when he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, don't be afraid to take yourself Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She shall give birth to a son. You shall call his name Jesus, for it is he who shall save his people from their sins. Now all this happened, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, and shall give birth to a son. They shall call his name Emmanuel, which is being interpreted, God with us. Joseph arose from his sleep and did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took his wife to himself, and he didn't know her sexually until she had given birth to her firstborn son. Now in those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment made when Quirinius was the governor of Syria. All went to enroll themselves, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city Nazareth, into Judea, to David's city, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to enroll himself with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him as wife, being pregnant. And while they were there, the day had come for her to give birth. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a feeding trough because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds in the same country, staying in the field and keeping watch by night over their flock. Behold, an angel of the Lord stood by them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. The angel said to them, Don't be afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy, which will be to all the people. For there is born to you today, in David's city, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. This is the sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth, lying in a feeding trough. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly army praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, on earth peace and goodwill toward men. When the angels went away from them into the sky, the shepherds said to one another, Let's go to Bethlehem now and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known unto us. They came with haste and found both Mary and Joseph, and the baby was lying in the feeding trough. And when they saw it, they publicized widely the saying which was spoken to them about the child. All who heard it wondered at the things which were spoken to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these sayings, pondering them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, just as it was told them. When 8 days were fulfilled for the circumcision of the child, his name was called Jesus, which was given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. Now, when the days of purification according to the law of Moses were fulfilled at 40 days, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, as it is written in the law of the Lord, every male who opens the womb shall be called holy to the Lord, and to offer a sacrifice according to which is said in the law, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. He came in the Spirit into the temple. When the parents brought in their child Jesus, that they might do concerning him according to the custom of the law, then he received him in his arms and blessed God and said, "Now you are releasing your servant, Master, according to your word in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all peoples, a light for revelation to the nations and the glory of your people Israel." Joseph and his mother were marveling at the things which were spoken concerning him. And Simeon blessed him and said to Mary, his mother, "Behold, this child is set for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and for a sign which is spoken against. Yes, a sword will pierce through your own soul, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed." There was one Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher, and she was of great age, having lived with a husband 7 years from her virginity, and she'd been a widow for 84 years, who didn't depart from the temple, worshiping with fastings and petitions night and day. Coming up at that very hour, she gave thanks to the Lord and spoke to them all these things who were looking for redemption in Jerusalem. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who is born King of the Jews? For we saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard it, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Gathering together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he asked them where the Christ would be born. And they said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for it is written through the prophet, 'You, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are in no way least among the princes of Judah, for out of you shall come a governor who shall shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them exactly what time the star appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when you have found him, bring me word, so that I may also come and worship him." They, having heard the king, went their way, and behold, the star which they saw in the east went before them, until it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. They came into the house and saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Opening their treasures, they offered to him gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Being warned in a dream they shouldn't return to Herod, they went back to their own country another way. That's the Christmas story. You know, we've been busy with Advent, and you've been busy with your own preparations. But we've been preparing here at church for today, the Christmas. But the Advent door is closing for this season because we're here. It's here. Christmas is here. You know, three verses can almost summarize the gospel. Oh, they're incomplete for sure. But in Isaiah 9:6, we read, "For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." And we read a section of Luke just a few minutes ago about the shepherds out in the field. And the shepherd said to the, or the angel said to those shepherds, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all your people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to him. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." Philippians 2, verses 8 and 10, the words of Paul. "And being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth." The Lord has made an announcement unto us. His Son is born. Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And angels proclaim the message to the shepherds. When they proclaimed that message to the shepherds, they were proclaiming it to us as well. And some traveled from afar as the Magi. In last night's video from David Jeremiah said they may not have even worshiped God, but they understood what God had done in bringing his Savior to the earth. And they traveled from afar, bringing them the gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. You saw in the video clip this morning, we heard it in the story, we heard it in the scripture from Luke. The shepherds hastily went into the city, the town of Bethlehem, to find the babe. And what did they do when they finished seeing the baby as they left that stable? They just didn't go back to the sheep and say, "Wow, that was pretty neat." No, no. They told everyone they could see. I've watched several versions of the Christmas story and read several versions and getting ready for today. And I still like the ending of the shepherd as one of my favorites. Because the shepherd had brought that, you know, the sheep that was blemished, the lamb, and he was rejected by one of the priestly court. And when that priest had seen saw that shepherd one more time, after he had just seen the baby, the Messiah, Jesus Christ, he said, "What are you doing here? Have you found the perfect lamb for sacrifice?" The shepherd didn't utter any words, but his smile told a wonderful story. Yeah, indeed. He found the perfect lamb for sacrifice. It's our perfect lamb for sacrifice. And today, as Advent season in preparation for Christmas draws to a close, we anxiously await with great hope for the second advent, when Christ will return and call his people home. Are you one of his people? If you are not, look to the manger today. There you will find our Lord and Savior, born to save the people from their sins. We have a great story to tell. People must know. Let's close with one more hymn, and then we'll go on our ways to celebrate Christmas.
Let's stand and sing in closing, "Go Tell It on the Mountains."
Shepherds caravan watching for the silent flocks by night. Behold throughout the heavens there shone a holy light. Oh, I say go, tell it on the mountains, over the hills and everywhere. Go, tell it on the mountains, Jesus Christ is born. Shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out an angel chorus to hail our Savior's birth. Down in a lowly manger the humble Christ was born, and God sent us salvation on that blessed Christmas morn. Oh, I say go, tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go, tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. I sought both night and day, and I asked the Lord to help me, and He showed me the way. He made me a watchman upon a city wall, and if I am a Christian, I am the least of all. Go, tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go, tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. Go tell it, go tell it, go on and tell it. Go tell it, go tell it, go tell it.
Amen.
Pondered a lot of things in her heart. I hope that you ponder that song throughout today as you go home. May it keep coming back and running through your mind. Go tell it on the mountain. That's a when Missy can break out the tambourine and Katie gets a jiving, you know we got a good song. Let's close in prayer. May you be filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the determination of the Magi, the peace of the Christ child. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Go tell it on the mountain, because the people must know.